see, in the styles that we hear all throughout this season. In part one of tonight's prelude, that's exactly what is in store for you. From our Southwestern singers to our piano ensemble to the Southwestern a cappella to the Texas Baptist Choir to a violin piano duet and to a jazz combo in the style of Frank Sinatra, or maybe for some of you, Michael Bublé, or a bit younger crowd, that might be. The first part of this is called Sounds of the Season. So as Dr. Ben Kasten directs Southwestern Singers and the Texas Baptist College Choir, you'll hear a joyful carol called Ding Dong Merrily on High.
Don't matter. rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. In Bethlehem in Israel this blessed babe was born, and laid within a manger upon this blessed morn, the which his mother Mary did now he take his scorn. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Fear not, then said the angel, let nothing you affright. This day is born a Savior of our pure virgin bride, to free all those who trust in him from Satan's power and might. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
When Jesus was born, the whole world told the story of his birth. This is a traditional French carol, now translated into English, tells the story of Christ's birth. Listen.
Jeanette, Isabella, bring a torch to the stable now. It is Jesus, good folk of the village, Christ is born, and Mary's calling, ah, ah, beautiful is the mother, ah, ah, beautiful is her son. Now, good folk of the village, hurry now, the Christ child to see. You will find him asleep in the manger, Jesus is born, and whisper softly, hush, hush, peacefully how he slumbers, hush, hush, peacefully how he sleeps.
Thank you, Michael. Jeremy. The students and the faculty of Texas Baptist College and Southwestern Seminary School of Church Music and Worship, we want you to know this. We've been praying for you. And specifically that through this evening, that your hearts and minds will be encouraged to reflect on the most amazing, the most mysterious, in the most hope-filled event in the history of mankind, the birth of Jesus Christ, the incarnation, God becoming one of us, Emmanuel, God with us. As you are well aware, and as Dr. Dockery mentioned in his opening comments, the birth of Christ was perfectly foretold and prophesied in numerous verses throughout the Old Testament with impeccable detail. So in part two of tonight's prelude, we'll be reminded of Christ as the Savior anticipated through carols and songs from our Texas Baptist College Band and Choir, our Seminary Music Academy Children's Choir, and a very, very special arrangement of O Come, Emmanuel that reflects the reality that truly Christ is the hope for all the nations. So as we begin this second part, listen to these words from the prophet Isaiah.
Living in the dark lands.
For to us a child is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. So this next song is an old hymn made new. And so we want you to be able to sing with us. So we're going to sing the first verse And you can remain seated for this, and then we're going to sing it again, and you'll stand with us. So let's sing, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus.
Come Thou Long Expected Jesus, born to set Thy people free. From our fears and sins release us, let us find our rest in Thee.
Stand with us and sing, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus.
Come Thou Long Expected Jesus, born to set Thy people free. From our fears and sins release us.
The prophet wrote specifically of Messiah, God with us, in Isaiah chapter 7, when he proclaimed, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin will conceive, give birth to a son, and she will name him Emmanuel." This next song will be presented to you in four languages: Korean, Hebrew, Spanish, and English. And I got my order wrong, so you can check and see which ones are right. But we wanted to present this to you in this way, not just as a reminder that Christ has come for the nations, but as a foretaste of heaven, when every tribe and tongue will gather together and sing to the one true King. This is O Come, Emmanuel.
Sim.
Thank you so much, ladies. You've just heard a very, very small sample of the global engagement that's taking place on this campus and the amazing reality that God has sent us students from over 40 different countries in nearly all 50 states. And we believe that we're seeing an incredible prelude of Revelation 5. And they sang a new song. You, Jesus, are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals. You purchased people for God by your blood from every tribe and language and people and nation. So as we face the task of sharing the gospel to the ends of the earth, we proclaim with the Apostle Paul, in the fullness of time, God sent his Son. Born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law so that we might receive adoption as sons. So in part three of tonight's prelude, listen closely to the texts of the songs and hymns and carols as we reflect on the miraculous birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Through the music of our Southwestern a cappella, the Southwestern Piano Quartet, the new Southwestern Men's Chorus, a vocal and guitar duet written by two of our performance majors, Gabrielle Neiser and her husband Matthew, adjunct voice professors Will Hughes and Katie Mersch, and now the Cowden Hall Band as they present What Christmas Really Means.
Our next song is called What Christmas Really Means. It is a journey from the manger to the cross, to the empty tomb, and to the resurrection. We want to invite you on this journey with us. So we're gonna teach you the chorus to the song. Is that all right? Excellent. So here's how it goes. You can remain seated as we learn together. Verse 14 says, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. Amen. Please stand and sing with us What Christmas Really Means.
We're invited to the sacred manger, where glory sleeps upon the hay, to bow in wonder at the mystery of all that is fulfilled this day.
Sing, oh hallelujah.
Oh hallelujah, where there was darkness, now heaven's light has intervened. A child is born.
To relive the journey.
The memory will lead us to the hillside.
Adore our King. You may be seated.
Hear the word of the Lord from Luke chapter 1. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man named Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came to her and said, "Greetings, favored woman. The Lord is with you." But she was deeply troubled by this statement, wondering what kind of greeting this could be. Then the angel told her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Now listen, you will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end."
Did you know? sons and daughters, did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, because he has looked with favor on the humble condition of his servant." You said, O Lord, that I would have a son. I was to call him Jesus. He would be the one that we've waited for. Oh, how we've waited for Messiah. But when I look at him, I see a child, my little baby peaceful mind. How will it come to be? Death defeated and sin undone, I lie at your feet, I am overcome. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. My soul magnifies the Lord from generation to generation. cross. 3 days go by, his body is not lost, is what we've waited for. Oh, how we've waited for Messiah. Mm-hmm.
such a flower, to be cast down in fullest hour. Rejoice today, this blessed morn, for fragrant bud of hope just born. Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, 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 sing alleluia.
Stood still long ago. There were shepherds in fields, or at least this is how the story goes. The story goes.
Woman with child and an inn with no room. Telling a tomb, this is how the story goes. But it's more than a fable, and it's more than a fairy tale, and more than my mind can conceive. The baby boy the angels called the Son of God.
Heaven's child, the great I am, born to take away my sin through nail-pierced hands. Still the story lives on. God's gift to us, sent to earth, wrapped in flesh, His only Son, His only Son.
Story.
We are so thankful for faculty artists like Will and Katie and students like Ivan. Perhaps you might be wondering about believing, like they were just singing in Emmanuel, God with us, the Lord Jesus Christ, who we've been singing about all evening. He was indeed born of a virgin. He lived a perfect life. He died in order to cleanse us from sin. And he was buried in a tomb, and on the third day he rose to prove that he is the Son of the living God, who has power over sin and death. The Apostle Paul wrote that if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Please know that if the Holy Spirit is prompting you to trust in Jesus Christ tonight, who is the only one who can forgive your sins and restore the relationship with the God who created you, any of us here, any of the students on the stage, any of our faculty would be honored to speak with you and answer any questions that you might have. The beautiful songs that you're going to hear next from our combined choirs, Southwestern Acapella, Southwestern Singers, Masters in Piano Performance Major Josh Jr., and three tenors who represent the three levels of our music instruction, undergraduate, master's level, and doctoral studies. All of these songs are musical celebrations of Jesus Christ, our Savior. So may you be encouraged by these musical offerings.
Calm and matchless love,
come let us adore. Even shall see. the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth.
A new and glorious morn.
Fall on your knees. Oh, hear the angel voices. Oh, night divine.
Oh.
Thank you, gentlemen. Grateful for that. Well, as our Christmas prelude celebrating Christ the Savior is born draws to a close, I'd like to invite all of the School of Church Music and Worship students back to the stage. And as they do that, we'd like to thank you again for coming tonight. If you enjoy this evening, come back tomorrow at 2 o'clock, or just tell your friends and have them come back and enjoy this with you. We would also like to thank Dr. David Dockery, our president, Dr. Madison Grace, our provost, for their outstanding leadership and their incredible support of our School of Church Music and Worship. We could not do what we do without them. We're also grateful for Jim Smith and the entire comms team for their help with programs and publicity, and Jim Bob Brown and all of the entire production team and the sound team and lighting technicians who made this evening possible. We're so grateful for them. To our SCMW stage managers and to the very capable leadership, under the capable leadership of Matthew Waymack, we are certainly grateful for all that he's done to help us. And our executive administrator of the School of Church Music and Worship, Mrs. Fran D. Wysocki, thank you so much. We're very grateful. I'm truly blessed to work with the best faculty anywhere. And I want to thank all of our faculty, the SCMW faculty, and especially Dr. Chuck Lewis, who is the producer and director of tonight's Prelude to Christmas. Thank you, Dr. Lewis. Thank you, faculty. And lastly, from my heart, I want to thank our students. They are the best students on the planet, and we are so grateful for all of you. Thank you, students, for what you've done. Their talent is only surpassed by their desire to serve the Lord Jesus Christ, and we're so grateful for them. It won't surprise you that an event like that, there are some expenses associated with a presentation like this one. And if you feel led, there'll be some people at the doors with baskets, and if you'd like to place a few dollars or a few hundred dollars in the baskets, we would be most grateful. If you'd like to write a check, simply make it out to SWBTS, and then in the notes line, you can put Prelude there. Also, please know that almost every single person, every single student you've seen tonight in this presentation is here under some kind of a scholarship. We're grateful for the cooperative program, but we'd also want you to know that you can invest in their scholarships for our music and worship students or for the seminary in general. And there is a Give to Southwestern link at the bottom of the digital program notes that we would be happy for you to look into, or I would be happy to speak to you as well at the end. So as we close tonight, again, thank you for being here, but we want to leave you with scripture. So listen to these words from Luke chapter 2. Chloe?
And the angel of the Lord said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby lying in a manger, wrapped in swaddling cloths. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased."
Joy to the world, the Lord is come, let earth receive a King.
You may be seated. We have seen, we have heard, we have felt and experienced the glory of God through the Son in the power of the Spirit. And tonight, as we conclude our time together, we'd like to sing a song of adoration with you. So please arise and join in with us. This is Oh Come All You Faithful. Yes, right back up. Thank you. With Only a Holy God. Church Music and Worship, thank you for spending the evening with us. And as you prepare to enjoy the holiday season, we pray that you would boldly proclaim that Christ the Savior is born. Thank you. Merry Christmas, and everyone have a good night. God bless you.